This morning, we are taking you on a new path, at least on your backyard.
Yeah, it's a product that we hope will blow you away, but not won't blow you away. I'm not sure if I said that right.
It will blow you away, but won't blow away, literally.
Al Green from BoodleBoxTV.com is joining us, and we're talking about a new walkway for perhaps your backyard, side yard, wherever you want to put it.
Yes, I'm going to show you a very easy way to install a flagstone patio, and with a little bit of a twist.
All right.
The product that I'm representing here today is called Gator Dust, and it goes in between the joints of the natural stone.
Okay. So take us through this aquarium that you have here.
This is just a mock-up to show a cross-section. What we're going to do is excavate the area that we want to build the patio or the walkway. Then we're going to install base, compact the base. That would be the bottom layer right there.
This is the base right here.
Yes, it's a base rock.
Okay.
Compact. And grade it so that when the water falls on your patio, that it runs off.
Okay.
And then we're going to install a layer of bedding sand, which is the next layer.
Okay.
Then you're going to place your flagstone.
Right on top.
Right on top of
and
that.
Al, this is what? This is a good, what, 8 to 12 inches right here, isn't
well,
it?
We're going to suggest about 5 inches of base. You can go a little bit less if you have very stable subsoil.
Okay.
But always more is better.
Okay. And then we shot a little bit of video yesterday of you guys actually installing one of these.
Yes.
So, and in, one of the things that, arguments that I have heard over the years is that this is a very expensive process. Would you agree, disagree?
Not at all, not at all. With this method that I'm going to show you, we're going to have the effects of an expensive mortared installation without the cost.
Okay.
You can see the fella here is installing the base rock. The first shot was with the plate vibrator. The second is the tamper, whichever you prefer to use.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's installing the bedding sand. That pipe right there is going to be used to level and screed the bedding sand. You'll see just in a minute how he's going to do that. So with the 2x4, he's laid down those pipes on top of the bedrock, the base.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's screeding, pulling that board across those pipes, and making the sand very, very level, making it easier to install the flagstone.
And how big an area are we talking about here? Is this a back patio?
Well, I've had people do areas as large as 1,200 feet.
Okay.
So you can go, you know, very 3 feet wide from your house to your garage or big patio, whichever you prefer. This is all for a walking surface, by the way, not driving. Now he's tamping the stones into place and using a level to make sure that they're all even.
Okay.
Now this is the Gator Dust. Now this is the joint material designed to prevent weeds, prevent erosion. Now it's activated by water, so he's cleaned it off very thoroughly, swept it about 1/8 of an inch below the top of the stones, and water activates this product and becomes very hard.
The compound. Interesting. Beautiful,
yes.
Isn't it?
Isn't it
so
nice?
How much money can we save by using something like this versus traditional mortar method?
Well, with a mortar method, you have to put in a concrete slab. So you have to pour a concrete slab, take the stones, mortar each stone into that, typically cut and fit and cut and fit, and then and mix the mortar mix, grout the each individual stone. With this right here, we don't have to pour the slab. We're not using grout. This product doesn't stain. So all you do is sweep it into the joints, clean it off, tamp the stones, blow it off with the blower, get it real clean, wet it, and now it's very, very rigid.
Voila!
We have samples of it right here.
Al, thanks for joining us this morning. Great advice.
Thank you very much.
Hard as a rock. All right, when we come back, we're going to talk about